Hello, and welcome back to another episode of Media Munchers. I'm Mapian.
And I'm Adrian.
And today we're going to start the podcast off with a little trailer review. Big A just brought to my attention that we have the Ghostbusters Afterlife that just came out not too long ago, and thought we'd get a little bit of a raw reaction, give our thoughts. So without further ado, take it away, Big Apple.
Sure.
You're a great mom.
I don't know. I'm fine with Trevor, but with Phoebe... She really keeps me on the outside.
That's normal.
She's an awkward, nerdy kid.
Damn.
Doritos cannon. Maybe a new home could be an opportunity to start fresh. I just wish she'd get into some trouble.
There's still time.
What are you doing here in Somerville, anyway?
We're completely broke, and our grandfather left us this creepy old farmhouse in the middle of nowhere.
Your father wasn't much of a homemaker.
He could hardly keep the power on.
You're saying he left us nothing?
Well, I wouldn't say nothing.
The machine.
You went with station wagon?
It's the only one that had an engine.
What is happening here?
Somehow. A town with no fault lines is shaking on a daily basis.
Maybe it's the apocalypse.
Egon came out here for a reason.
Are you troubled by strange noises in the middle of the night?
Do you experience feelings of dread in your basement or attic?
Have you or any of your family ever seen a spook, specter, or ghost?
Casual murder.
Oh my god.
But it's okay.
You guys hear that?
Something's coming.
The whole city. It's like the Walking Dead.
All right.
Ghostbusters, we're ready to believe you.
We're closed.
No way.
Okay.
All right. Okay, hold on. I have so many thoughts now. Just right off the beginning.
Yeah.
Okay, first of all, Ghostbusters by nature has always been like a comedy, no? I mean, they've always been a comedy first before everything else. This trailer felt really epic. Like, it felt like they were taking it seriously, the lore, and, like, it wasn't just cheap jokes or anything like that.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not even going to lie to you. I didn't even see the remake, the one that was in New York a few years ago. I didn't even see it, because I was like, eh. I was turned off.
Yeah, it looked okay.
It looked like an SNL sketch, like, but it was a movie. You know what I mean?
Yeah, I was like, eh.
So, and all the reviews seemed to back that up. So I was like, you know, maybe one day I'll go back and watch it really inebriated or something. But... this one is different because it seems like they're respecting the original, but they're going in a new direction. Like they have a whole new reason for having the gear.
Yeah. Am I mistaken or is this one tied to the original?
Yeah, it definitely, they imply, especially in that last shot, that it's like the same universe and they're calling up, I honestly forgot his name, but one of the original dudes.
Right, Bill Murray.
Bill Murray, right?
Yeah, whatever his, I haven't actually watched.
It wasn't, to me it looked like Akron, or it sounded like him.
Oh, was it?
Or is that his name? Am I saying it wrong?
I assumed it was
Bill Murray.
Bill Murray.
It could be Bill Murray because he was kind of like
more synonymous.
Yeah, with the brand. That makes more sense. So yeah, I like how they're doing a callback. Like maybe he'll help him for the final thing. That's cool. This showed a lot more of what, like the premise of the movie and the setup and all the minute details than like because we got a trailer like a few months ago, no, or almost a year ago.
Yeah, we think so.
It was a small trailer. It was basically there was a lot of this in it, but it was much more of a teaser than it was like an actual trailer.
Right.
So this one gets me excited. Like, when is that supposed to come out?
Yeah, I think it said Thanksgiving.
Oh, yeah, it did.
Yeah, it did.
Man. Okay, cool. Yeah.
Yeah, it does look really interesting.
I'm loving what I'm seeing. They brought back the car, of course. I like that. I'm pretty sure that's new. That I don't know, like, the thing that captures the ghosts and the specters, like, that on wheels, though. Like, they put it on an RC car.
Yeah.
That's pretty neat. Keeping up with a real car.
Right.
Overall, it looks good. Like, fresh faces. I'm really interested to see how big Paul Rudd's role is going to be. Like if he's
it seems almost like he's the maybe the main character.
It feels like that, but I feel like there's a lot of emphasis on the kids. like a new generation.
Yeah, that too.
It's kind of like we skipped over what Paul Rudd's would have been like in the early 2000s, and we're going straight to the kids.
You know, I kind of hate to say it, but it does kind of feel like it is a little bit like Stranger Things in that way.
Yeah, yeah, you think so?
Yeah,
yeah, because it just feels bit, like.
But it does seem like it is going to be a little bit. It's going to be different.
Right. I'm sure they're going to have their own unique Ghostbusters spin on it, but it's just like, I wonder how much they're going to walk that line between how much is it Paul Rudd being the main draw and like the main character versus like the kids coming of age, them learning to be like, is it like going to be like a family ordeal business now? It seems like that's what they're going for, but I just really, how much of that balance are they going to strike? Right, you know what I mean? So overall, it's a great trailer. I'm really honestly excited for it, and we'll definitely be checking that one out, Big A.
Yeah, I think so.
For sure. All right, cool. When we come back from a small little break, we'll be reviewing Black Widow. All right, and we're back with a review of Black Widow. And without further ado, I'm just going to jump into this by saying it's better late than never, and I'm glad we got it. And spoiler alert, this movie kind of serves as a function to like the future of the Black Widow title of Black Widow, you know, as a character moving on, since obviously Natasha Romanoff died at the end of Endgame. Yeah. I get them confused. It's all one movie to me. But yeah, she sacrificed herself, right? So this is kind of like a prequel sequel in a way. Mm-hmm. And with that being said, we start with this really awesome opening sequence. Like from the jump, it's just like this really gritty cover of like, I even forget the name of the song, but it's that Kurt Cobain song, like All Just Entertainers. I forget what it's called. Yeah. But it was really like intense. There's like an intensity to it. And I think what it is it's Marvel's way of saying like, even though we can't explicitly show everything she's done, like she's a bad mofo. Like this organization, they've done like straight up crimes.
Some dark
stuff. And they're alluding to all of that. They're alluding to all the political ties, all the dark backroom stuff. So we're getting a pretty good picture, and it's setting a pretty good tone of the movie. Where that clashes is later on, like the movie has some dark undertones, but it's still a Marvel movie. And it's still kind of like comedic at times and lighthearted and family oriented. And it's just kind of like, okay, that's fine. But like when you don't really pick up a majority side, you end up just towing the line in the middle, and it doesn't make for either too effective comedy or too effective drama. It's just kind of like meh.
Yeah, it was in the middle of the road, sort of
a little too middle of the road
with its tone. Yeah,
yeah. It's so like they had hints and glimmers of it, and I'll make this analogy a few times this review, but it feels like this easily could have been like a Disney Plus series, and like they could have taken more time on different aspects or even scenes of her life. But of course it needed to be a movie because that's when it was made, and one and done kind of deal. Mm-hmm. But so this movie had tried to be a bunch of different movies in one, is what it felt like to me.
I got the same thing.
Same vibes. And then this is what threw me for a loop. And the prologue, when they're in Ohio and they're a seemingly perfect family and they're undercover Russians posing as Americans and all that, I really, really thought Natasha was the younger girl. Mm-hmm. Like, I didn't think it was the girl with the colored hair and stuff.
Yeah, I feel like they kind of didn't get actresses that matched, and that it's sort of like, threw you off in the beginning, because it didn't really feel like you were in a Marvel movie watching Black Widow.
Mm-mm. Which in a certain way is okay, because they are undercover and their identities are very much that of children, and one of them's obviously pretending, and like as we learn later that Yelena really much was that 6-year-old, and this was her reality, even though like I don't think she entirely knew that it was fake, or even if she did know, she didn't really see it that way. Like it was real to her. Yeah. Like we emotionally get from her later in the movie. But my point in saying all that is that, it intentional or not, I got misdirected. And it was really cool to see that from a young age, she was proficient and she like knew Russian, obviously, of course. And like even, I think it was Dreykov was the big bad's name. Right. He saw that, right? And then, what's Hellboy's name?
Dude, I have it right
here. Dude, please pull it up.
David Harbour.
Harbour, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Harbour's character was like, you know, hey, Alexi. He was calm down, like, you know, put your gun away, it's fine, it's gonna be okay, you're gonna be fine. And I was like, man, this is some shady stuff, because, like, they really set him up to be a family. And, like, you could see from the kid's point of view, it was really just, it was just gut-wrenching when, like, they had to go back to work, essentially. They're just pawns. Mm-hmm. And so all of that to say, they had that awesome, you know, plane scene. That was really cool, like, action off the jump. And then they get away, and, of course, that happens. Dreykov, you know, splits the girls up, but she keeps that little photo with her. Natasha gives it to Yelena, right?
Yeah, I believe.
And later on, that's her calling card to say, hey, you know, I'm back. It was really good setup in that regard. But then we get to modern day Black Widow. And this is just after Civil War, right? So she's on the run. She's a fugitive. Mm-hmm. Dude, that thing, her whole friendship with that guy who can get her like planes and stuff and random like relocator, that middleman. like, we're just kind of thrown into it. And I'm like, okay, but what's their relationship? You know what I mean? Yeah, like, how far back did they go? You just kind of accept it, right? You're like, okay, just accept it. And I was like, all right, cool, I guess. And there was just like some small, like genuine moments. Like, she's just chilling, watching movies in an RV. I'm like, good for you. She's like listening to Cheap Thrills or whatever. Yeah. And then bam, Taskmaster is like put on her. And I'm like, whoa, okay. And what's your hot take on Taskmaster? What do you think? Did you like what they did with Taskmaster's character?
I think it sort of works with the movie.
Right.
But I also kind of feel like they might have just been better off presenting her as, because the reveal ends up being that it's Dracov's daughter.
Right.
Her just being like another Black Widow.
Mm.
I feel like it would still present the same sort of like tonal shift that, or storyline that they were trying to imply.
Yeah, I thought it was interesting that it was such a personal connection to Natasha's character, because she was collateral damage from the red on her ledger when she did assassinate Dracov the first time, like years ago. And of course, you know, daughter's still alive and she's very much messed up, you know, as she would be. So I think they were going for a more gut-wrenching, like, twisted, this is really messed up, and like, look at your past. It's literally in your face. Like, I think they were trying to go for that for Natasha, but it just kind of rubbed me the wrong way, because, yeah, it was a twist, but it was one that I really wasn't expecting. Like, I'm not, like, a comics buff, but I'm pretty sure Taskmaster was, like, his own character, right?
Yeah, they definitely...
did their own little...
Yeah, they did their own little spin for the story.
And like I said, it sort of fits, like, within the context of this movie. It works. It really threw me for a loop. And so I was like, okay.
Yeah.
So that was one of the things that didn't sit 100% right with me, but, like, I guess it worked. You know what I mean? And that's another thing, too, is, like, all this, you know, badass action happens. Yelena was great. Whoever, I forget the actress's name, she was amazing comic relief. She kind of stuck out. She was, like, one of the only
Florence Pugh.
Florence Pugh. Yeah, she's been in other stuff, too. I just don't watch it. But she's a good actress.
Yeah, and she is.
Hey, did you have a beef with everyone's Russian accents? Like, everyone was shitting on it.
With David Harbour specifically, I felt like he kind of fell off
a few times
with his Russian accent. But I also think that it kind of helps with the story, because
it kind of justifies it. If he had to play American.
Because they had to play Americans for a while, and then going back to Russia, obviously, they're not
fully. Yeah.
Enveloped in the language the entire time.
I bet you someone would argue with you that after all that time in prison, though, you think he would have fallen back into his old habits.
Yeah, exactly.
So we can break our backs all day giving them excuses, but to me, it didn't bother me that much, because I was like, seriously, like, who are you offending? Russians? Like, I mean, but it works, though. You can justify it. Like, they had to play Americans.
I don't know that I could say, though, that it was maybe as bad as, like,
people make it out to
Wanda.
Oh, yeah, that was kind of the Sokovian. That was kind of a little...
It was a little...
yeah.
It was a little worse.
A little... Yeah. Yeah, that was noticeably worse. Way more noticeably. But that didn't bother me too much. Like I said, there were some good moments. Like, they played, like, the comedy of, like, the family. And, like, we're not a family. We are a family. And Natasha has to keep herself guarded. And, like, no, I felt like we were a family, too. And all that stuff at the end. And all these twists. There's twist on twist and twist. Like, forgive me, I forget who played her fake mother, or the character name, rather. But,
Is Melina?
Melina, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so, like, when Melina, like, turns them in, she's like, I'm sorry, they're on their way. And I'm like, oh, man, that sucks. Yeah. Like, I thought what they had was special. I guess not. So it's all business. But then, like, twist on top of that. Like, then her and Natasha figure out how they're gonna, like, go ahead and take down Dracov. And, like, the whole pheromone thing at the end. I was like, okay, that's kind of trippy, but I guess that works. Like, just weird, like, plot blockades and twists. I was like, this is really interesting.
Yeah, they're all trying to one-up each other after one-up.
It felt like a heist movie in that regard. It's like, oh, you thought of that? I knew you were going to think of that, so I thought of this. And I was like, all right, like, okay. But I will say this. Overall, I was entertained, and it was nice diving into her backstory, because we never really got her own solo movie until it was after she died. But the movie tried to be a lot and do a lot. And while it did set up for the future and all that good stuff, which we'll get into in a moment here, I was like, man, overall, this was a lot, but then also not much at the same time. You know what I mean? Like, it was bittersweet. Like, for me, the stakes weren't there, because I was like, well, she's going to live. She has to.
Right.
Infinity War and then Endgame. Like, she's going to triumph at the end, right? So, like, for me, some of the stakes weren't there and that kind of thing. But, I mean, overall, I was still entertained. I was just kind of like, it felt like, and then, of course, with the pandemic delaying it a whole year and a half, and, like, the hype kind of coming and going and coming and going. Like, it just,
it was terrible.
It didn't hit as hard as it could have for me. You know what I mean? So, like, even if it did come out release day as it was supposed to, and let's say it's a 7 or an 8, to me, it's closer to like a 5 or 6 now, because it's like, eh. You know what I mean? Like, it was still good, but like, eh. There's head gripes, you know?
Yeah. I think one of the bigger issues was that the focus should have been on Black Widow, but they had kind of shifted it more towards Yelena.
Yeah. Yeah, well, I mean, because in a way, it was her prequel. I mean, her origin story, if you would.
Her, like, prelude.
Yeah, into her being... Mm-hmm. So, like, it teetered the line between Black Widow solo film versus, like, Yelena's, like, origin movie. Origin. Mm-hmm. So she was kind of like a co-star in her own movie. You know what I mean? Yeah. So, like, it's like we almost didn't get too much on Black Widow, which in hindsight, I guess it makes sense. But it's exactly as you said. They focused more on Yelena moments and the Black Widows as a whole, which, of course, they had to for the plot. And I was just like, I felt like... Even though she got her own movie, she was still kind of did dirty. You know what I mean?
Yeah, she was still kind of like in the background.
Yeah, in the background as opposed to like the foreground. And I'm like, damn. Well, it's okay. I mean, she made her money. She'll be alright. She'll be alright. But anything can happen. You know, we'll see. Let's talk about that quick post credits real quick. Mm-hmm.
It was kind of shoehorned.
You felt that too, right? Yeah.
Yeah.
I was like,
and I'm still curious. She has a long name.
What are you talking about? Mrs. So and so and so?
Val.
We'll just call her Val. Yeah, let's call her Val.
Don't call her Val, but call her Val.
But call her Val, for sure. Call her Val. Yeah.
I'm still trying to figure out, like, what her deal is.
She's just an edgier.
She's kind of, like, tossed in there.
Really?
At no point in the movie or even before with the Falcon and Winter Soldier, mm-hmm. there was no, real like tied to her story, like,
not really. She's kind of like, hey, I'm building a team. Yeah, she's kind of like an edgier, cooler Nick Fury, but for like anti-heroes, I guess.
Mm-hmm.
Or like people who are less than good.
Yeah, because her character in the comics is supposed to be the head of Hydra, I believe.
Okay.
Or
spoiler,
she's supposed to be creating the like anti-Avengers.
Right. Yeah, and I can see that. Yeah, like Dark Avengers or anything. Like I said, the less than heroic Avengers, it seems like what she's putting mm-hmm. together. But what's interesting is that her target is now Hawkeye. And I'm like, what are they doing with this guy's character? Because Jeremy Renner, not getting into his personal, he's got he's a liability to Disney at some point. Like he's rough, man. He's rough as like a personal character. But they're already setting up the next generation for like, I guess, young Avengers, where he's mentoring... Mm-hmm. I don't know her name, but she's mentoring like the next Hawkeye, right? Whether it's his daughter or some random female protege, he's mentoring her. Now, if he's on the run, and he's supposed to be a good guy, a former Avenger, whatever, but now he's being hunted by Yelena. Like, there's so much gray area that we're about to go into that I don't even know how to keep up with it. Like, we're just gonna have to watch and see what happens. And does that imply that Yelena is gonna be crossing over into the Hawkeye series now on Disney Plus?
I believe that's what they're going for.
Okay, already. That makes sense.
But yeah, I just felt like the scene was pretty corny for it to be tying Hawkeye into this.
Yeah. The way I thought we were going to see what happened in Budapest, but I guess not. They alluded to what happened? Like they had to hold it down?
Yeah, they were correcting how to pronounce it, and I was...
Budapest.
Almost, like, that's where they left it.
Yeah. I was like, all that payoff, I mean, all that setup for, like, virtually no payoff, I'm like, all right, then, I guess. But like I said, like the movie's middle of the road, man. Like they tried to do a lot and then mm-hmm. they ended up doing a little bit of everything, but not too much of any one thing. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And you just kind of got left feeling like, okay, that was cool. You know?
Where do you think this ranks out of
like all of the MCU films?
Yeah.
It's, you know,
I would put this, it's definitely higher than Thor 2.
I'll tell you this for sure. Yeah. A lot of things are higher than Thor 2. for sure. It's probably in the middle of the rankings for me.
Yeah,
maybe mid lower. We'd have to do like a ranking someday. Maybe we'll do it at the end of each year.
Okay,
we'll do that. That'll be fun. We'll do that. Yeah. But it's definitely like it's not up there, man. It's not top five. I don't even think it breaks top 10, to be honest with you. Because how many movies are there? Like almost close to 22,
24
at this point. Yeah.
Yeah. Around
so there. It barely. If it gets top 14 or top 12, maybe.
Yeah.
For me, and that's like that's generous.
Yeah, I feel like it's close to maybe like an Iron Man 3.
Yeah, like it's about that same level.
Yeah.
And at least Iron Man 3 had some entertaining moments. I mean, this did too, don't get me wrong. But like visually and like all the suits at the end, like oh, that was cool. You know what I mean?
Yeah, I feel like we were also a little bit let down with the action scenes.
With Into Black Widow?
Yeah, in Black Widow. Yeah. Because often like it was the same action like choreography that they were using that Black Widow does all the time.
Yeah. I did like the meta humor. I like Yelena.
Yeah, the meta humor
was cool.
It was funny.
Like, not liking the landing and all that. Yeah. That was cool. She's like, I don't pose. She's like, you totally pose.
Yeah. And then she posed and she was like,
ugh. That was hilarious. That was awesome.
Yeah. I think that's a testament to Florence Pugh and her charisma.
Yeah, for real. It just oozes it. I'm like, Okay, yeah. I like her. I like her a lot. She's cool. Another thing too, while we're on the topic, is Black Widow just like a super soldier? Because she was taking some falls and hitting some pipes like Spider-Man. And
yeah,
I'm like,
she was.
Bro.
Yeah, that big fall.
Like,
she
the huge,
just lands
like the,
on her feet.
The 50-foot one.
Nothing
I'm like, more. You're invincible? Or you're supposed to be just a normal human. Like,
yeah, like even Spider-Man in the
remember,
second one.
Yeah, remember Raimi? He's like, oh, my back.
Yeah, yeah, that one. But even Tom Holland's Spider-Man. He
gets hurt. He's all bloodied and like, yeah, he's like, he's injured. And like, it takes a minute for him to get healed. I'm like, where are the stakes, man? Like, she's literally invincible this whole movie. You can't touch her.
Well, she did break her nose.
And then she broke it right back into place. And she's fine. Perfect. Flawless skin. Come on now.
But, a little bit of blood.
I mean, a little bit. I mean, that's just for the cameras, man. She'll just be like, I'm done. But anyway, yeah, I mean, listen. My point is this. Stakes were low. I knew she was going to triumph the whole way. You know what I mean? And you could argue that for most films. Like, MCU or otherwise, you can argue that most of the time they're going to win. They'll find a way. But like, at least let me pretend. At least let me have the illusion that maybe they won't. You know what I mean? This was broken for me. And there was a lot of good, but it was still middle of the road for me. So those are my thoughts on Black Widow as a whole. Any final ones from you?
No, yeah. I mean, that's just about it. Mm-hmm. I would say the same thing. It's
hard.
It's okay, but...
Yeah, but it's like...
Yeah, I wish it was better because, like, being that this is the send-off, you would want more.
A little more a little more treatment from it, you know what I mean? A little more, maybe a little more fan service. I don't know what that would look like, but just a little more, I don't know, respect towards it. I don't know. I didn't write it. I'm sure they did the best they could. But yeah, it's fine. It's okay. Yeah. you know, at least you can't call us like Marvel shills. We're honest. Anyway, those are our thoughts on Black Widow the movie. And you know, come back next time where we'll do something. We'll do something. All right. For Media Munchers, I'm Mathian.
And I'm Adrian.
And we're going to sign off.